Okay, I want to show you Haulroad design using MineScape 2021. So the first thing we have to ensure is surface engineering product is loaded. Okay, you don't have to load these. You can lazy load those afterwards. You have the project you want to work in. You have a topography you want to work with. In this case, you can see my topography. And you have your center line created where you want to put your haul road. So that's as easy as it is to get started with haul road design. So what I'll do is now fire up haul roads. First thing you need to do is do some road settings. And in this case, I called it DM. So you set up spacing, grade, your controls of how your design's going to go. Or be built. Now you can set that design because you can have multiple defaults up or designed. Now I'll go to design settings. I'll make sure I've got my layer naming correct. You can see it's based from my road settings and the design spec name. So it concatenates the two. What colors I want for my design. Where does my design live? And my templates. And of course, it gives you the status of what you're doing. I can set that design. So now I'm ready to go. So I've done the setup. Now I can set some parameters for my stationing, how I want to see my long section, how I want to do my cut and fills, how I want to build my cross sections. And of course, you can set up any curves. So if I look at chainage labels, I call this station. And I'm going to have these variables or values. These are how I want to see those labels when I turn them on. This is how I want the long section to look. These are the display items I want. These are the tag points I want to look at. There's the controls I want to use for the visuals. How do I want to do cut fill? So you can have different parameters for cut and fill. In this case, I'm not using a bench method. You can actually bench your cuts and your fills if you wanted to. This is going to have none. Set up some heights, berm widths, whatever slope you want. So you have total control of your parameters and you can change them as you go. Cross sections. This is how I want the cross sections to look when I create them, label them. Curve type. I just use the standard curve because I can control it. You also can do transitional, circular, or transitional curves. You can draw a line or pick your alignment. In this case, I'll go ahead and pick the alignment, but I'll turn off my triangulation. So there's my design, center line of my design. So I'll pick it. And if you've already done it, it's going to ask you if you want to recreate it. So what it does is it starts putting your stationing on here. Now what I want to do is go ahead and apply our horizontal curves. So if we just select curve, select what you want to curve. And you see all I'm doing is this interactive. Makes it pretty easy because I know I'm not going to exceed any of my radius. So that is complete. Next thing you have to do is now what I want to do is put some vertical curves on there to come up with my cut fill. So I'll go ahead and drape this line string element. So after it's draped, I'm just going to bring this up in the long section and use this specification I created earlier. If you notice it, this is the reference that I had set up in my controls for long section. And so what it does is it starts from point one and it just gives you an overall slope of your line string. It just gives you an average grade of those. So what I want to try to do now is this is topography, the red line. This yellow line is what I need to adjust for my topography and adjust my cuts and fills. So I'm just going to quickly go through this. So if I go in here and insert a vertex, so I may want to bring that down. Insert one here. I bring it back in the long section. So after we've done the vertical alignment, we think it's good. We've laid out the cut fill, our percentages of our road looks good. We just save, and that just brings it back in the top view for you on your alignment. The next thing we have to do is we have to apply our templates. A template is it's a design of how you want to lay out your haul road. So if I open up another CAD editor, I'll show you this. So I've got a design file out here where I've created all my templates. Put this in front view. If I just hit go back to the top or the home ribbon, hit front view. These are all my templates that I've built. And so you can see I have a crown 20. I've done some berms, just trying to do different design work on this. All these different fill angles and types, cuts, and so on and so forth. So it's up to you, however you want to build these templates. So there's tools within the Haulroad package to help you build these templates. So I'll go ahead and close this. So if I go back to Surface Engineering Haulroads, and again, I just need to apply the templates. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply a crown, 20 meter crown road that has just a grade to it. I hit apply, and if you notice there, I said complete road. So you'll only see it on the points, like point of intersection, point of tangent, the curve point, but it's actually going to be applied for the entire road. And you'll see it here in just a minute. So after I've applied the templates, now I could generate the road. So what I'll do is apply a cut and a fill to this road. And if I center and rotate, turn off this. You'll start seeing how these templates have been applied to the road. So there's cut, there's filled. You'll see it here in a minute, but it knows, MineScape knows which template to apply where based on how it draped it on the topography. So now if I do the cut fill, what it's going to do now is it's going to lay out the cuts and the fills for you and give you a polygon around that area so you could see it here. You can see we even had a transition. Here's a cut, here's the fill. The next thing we'll do after we've done our cut fill is we're going to generate the surface. Basically, we're going to generate a triangulated surface. So now I've generated the surface. Let's look at the surface. And if I go to layers, we've given you a set of tools or some function to go ahead and turn on what you need. So I'm going to just turn on the batter surface, and it's a triangulated surface. And if I go to render order, so now you can see how the triangulated surface was built. And you could change exaggeration also, so you can see the cuts and the fills, what I've done on this road. Okay, so after the surfaces have been created, You generate the cross sections. That's where you're going to get your volume. And you'll get a whole set of cross sections to come up for you. Station that I had set, I'll get a cross section. It shows the current surface. It shows where all the breakpoints are from my template. All these are a breakpoint for the template. It also shows you the cut and fill. And now if I go back to the row design and I hit cross section, this will be filled out with volume. So each station, each cross section will show you the cut and fill at that station. To get the volumes in a table, the cut fill volumes, I just hit surfaces and it does a cut fill. And you can see in this design, our cut was this, our fill. So the net was 69,000, which is pretty good over that entire length. These can be plotted out and sent out to the field, and they can actually get staked. You also have the capability or the ability to generate a plot design of your haul road design too. So after you've looked at your cross sections, you're comfortable with the design, you can go ahead and just compare your design surface with your topography. And that's what I'm just displaying here. So I can see where the cuts are, where the fills are. Just walk through this if you need to, so you get an idea of what's going on. See what's happening. You can see a lot of fill there. And you can also animate. You can walk through this haul road if you wanted to. So that could be found at the home, the view under the home tab. And there's a walkthrough.